ओम विश्वम दर्पण दृश्यमान नगरी तुल्य निजांतर्गतम पश्यन्नात्मनि मायया बहिर्बोधभूतं यथा निद्रया यस्साक्षात्कुरुते प्रबोधसमये स्वात्मानमेवाद्वयं तस्मै श्रीगुरुमूर्तये नमः इदं श्रीदक्षिणामूर्तये बीजस्यान्तरिवाङ्कुरो जगदिदं प्राग्निर्विकल्पं पुनः मायाकल्पितदेशकालकलना वैचित्र्यचित्रीकृतम् मायावीव विजृम्भयत्यभिमहायोगी वयस्वेच्छया तस्मै श्रीगुरुमूर्तये नमः इदं श्रीदक्षिणामूर्तये तस्मै श्रीगुरुमूर्तये नमः इदं श्रीदक्षिणामूर्तये ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् ॐ वर्स 193 अन्योन्याध्यासरूपः असौ असावन्नलिप्तपटो यथा घटितेनैकतामेति तद्वद्भ्रान्त्यैकतां गतः सो अप टू वर्स 187 विद्यायन डिस्कस्ड दिस तत्पदार्थ ईश्वर एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ एंड ऑफ कोर्स द बेसिस वाज मांडुक्य मंत्र एष योनि ही सर्वस्य दैट वाज द लास्ट एट्रीब्यूट वी डिस्कस्ड ईश्वर इज सेड टू बी द जगत कारण From, and then from verse 188, Vidyaranya raised an objection. The purpose of objection is to think about this vachyartha and lakshyartha of a tatpada. And it's very common mistake which is occurring is Ishvara and Brahman are one. One, that is okay. But then if Ishvara is a jagat karanam, Brahman is a jagat karanam. So, well, then we will have to understand. We may use it, or Shastra uses, in terms of words, etc. But in terms of concept, it's not one and the same thing. One is a Chidabhasa, one is a original. So, one is consciousness, one is a reflected consciousness. They are not one. Reflected consciousness is non-separate from, original. That's a different issue. And so what is Jagat Karanam has to be understood properly. And then, we want to understand, but we understand through Shastra. Then Shastra should take care. Somebody raised this question. Yeah, if you are saying, then Ishvara and Brahman are not one, no problem. But then when we, all this thing, Ishvara and Brahman, we know through what? Through Shastra. What Shastra? Shastra does not have any discrimination. It's a very serious issue. And therefore, if Shastra through which Shastra is a Pramana, through which we know Ishvara and Brahman, if Shastra itself does not discriminate properly, then how do you expect us to know? So that's how this, you know, all these verses we are discussing. So basically, this objection to this Jagat Karan Brahma, etc., Esha Sarvasya Yonihi, etc., has to be understood. And why Shastra well uses indiscriminately also, it is to be understood. Shastra may well go along with you. Shastra may go along with you as the ignorant person doesn't know there are two things. He does a mistake since beginningless time. Since beginningless time, he is mistaking Chidabhasa and Chit. Otherwise, how he calls himself as an individual? When he says he is an individual, even though the reality he is Brahman, means he is taking as a one. And therefore, this is a mistake he is committing since beginningless time. So Shastra goes along with you and takes one both the things as one. So like that's what Jiva is Brahman, and Jiva leaves this body and acquires a new body. So then tell us clearly, Jiva is Brahman, then there is a question of acquiring another body. Jiva travels and Jiva does not travel. If Jiva is Brahman, he doesn't travel. If Jiva definitely leaves the body and goes to the acquires another body, means he travels. So what is right, what is wrong? So could you follow? So this is a why. So Tatpada Lakshyartha and Tatpada Vachyartha has they are different, and he's preparing a ground for Mahavakya. Now he the slowly Mahavakya will also appear. So this what we were discussing, Esha Yonihi Sarvasya and Sarveshwara Sarvash, I mean Sarvagnya and Sarvantaryami, all this we were discussing. That is Ishvara. Well, that is Brahman. Brahman and Ishvara are one. No. So this Tatpada Vachyartha and Lakshyartha are different. That's what they want to convey ultimately. So that is how a Purapaksha was raised. And so according to the context, we should be able to take a appropriate meaning. That is, according to context, even though the single, I mean the same word is used, we have to take appropriate meaning. So Jiva is Brahman, that word Jiva is there. And Jiva travels from leaving this body, goes to another loka, another acquire another body. There also the word Jiva only is used. But context, what is the sentence? Jiva acquires a body, etc. Okay, Chidabhasa. Jiva is Brahman, then definitely it is a, it's not Chidabhasa. And therefore, basically, one is a Lakshyartha, one is a Vachyartha. All this has to be understood. So Shastra will not, you don't expect Shastra that they should not use these words. Shastra will use the words. You understand it depending upon the context. You take an appropriate meaning. That is what Vidyaranya wants to clarify. And therefore, he is telling this. And three things are already together in Ishvara's Tatpada Vachyartha. Three things are there. OC and the original consciousness, reflected consciousness, that is Chidabhasa and reflecting medium. And no one is separate from anyone. Right? There is no, you cannot separate consciousness from its reflection. I mean, you can't separate means basically wherever the reflection is, there the consciousness. That's what I want to convey. And reflecting medium, the Maya, and reflection cannot be separated. Reflecting medium and original Brahman also cannot be separated. Well, Maya is definitely is non-separate from Brahman, and therefore none of them can be separate. And what the definition of Ishvara, which involves all the three things, none of them can be separated from each other. So, what Brahman is used to refer original consciousness or reflected consciousness of this mixture, since they cannot be separated. Similarly, word Ishvara also is loosely used to indicate Brahman or even a Chidabhasa, reflected consciousness, etc. And so we should, these two are mixed, I mean consciousness or the reflected consciousness are mixed up by the Shastra, but according to the context, we should take the meaning. Shastra provides the context, and Shastra tells which word, I mean, which meaning should be taken in which context, that also Shastra tells. Then don't blame Shastra. Shastra tells you clearly which meaning should be taken in which context, either Chidabhasa or original, that Shastra has conveyed. My mind is taking appropriate, well, definitely, in a appropriate con in a different context. Well, that training has been given by Shastra. And therefore, please don't blame Shastra. That why Shastra should use one word for two things if they are not one. Why Shastra should use one word for two different meanings when there is, when, I mean, they are not one. And therefore, but Shastra will use. But basically, you should understand according to the context. Anyway. So this is how Vaidika works. You know, Vaidika will fight for whatever Veda says. We should not blame Veda. In any case, we should not blame Veda because it's a Paurusheya, and we should understand it properly. So according to context, we should take the meaning. And so word karanam, when you say karanam, automatically you should drop Brahman. Word karan. Even though they have said word Brahman. Brahman is the one which from which the whole creation came. Tasmad vai, tasmad atmanaha akasha sambhuta. Tasmad brahmanaha akasha sambhuta. Even the word Brahman is used. But the moment karanatvam comes, karanatvam is an attribute on Brahman, superimposed basically. It's an attribute on superimposed on Brahman. And when karanam comes, everything comes. Karanam comes means definitely it is a related to karya. That's how karan karya sambandha is there. Then how can that Brahman, which has a relation, well, sangha, sambandha, will be a sangam. And therefore, we should understand, well, when they say, asangohi ayam purushaha, or else in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, somewhere else also it is said, ashiryo nahi shiryate, agruhyo nahi gruhyate, asango nahi sajjate, etc., etc., in Brihadaranyaka, in fourth chapter. So, asango nahi sajjate, or asangohi ayam purushaha, that also is Brahman. Oh, then when when you say that Brahman is karanam, so karanam means then sangha comes, sambandha comes, becomes sasangam. So then definitely this is different. So when Brahman has been shown as a karanam, never take it as a nirgunam Brahman or asangam Brahman. Definitely, because karanatvam indicates a sambandha. And sambandha to what? Sambandha to karya. Karan karya sambandha will be there. And automatically time also comes. Time. When really, you know, when Srishti is about to come, then Brahman is karanam. So therefore, karanam also, well, is related to definitely time. Karya is related to time, then karanam also is related to time. So this, well, definitely a timeless Brahman, etc. Well, that is not at all in the picture. And so, anyway, so when Brahman is Jagatkaram, like Taittiriya, etc., says that, well, Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, and Tasmad Brahmanaha, Akasha Sambhuta, etc., whole creation has come. Then Upanishad, well, definitely says, Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma is attributeless Brahman. No relation. No relation to what? No relation to what? No relation to time. Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, that Brahman is not related to time, not related to place, not related to any object. Either you are related to you, the Brahman, okay? You, the Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, that is you, that is you are not related to time, you are not related to object, you are not related to any place. That is the meaning, actually, Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma. Brahman is not Brahman is not related to anything. And then tasmat brahmanaha, tasmat vaye tasmat, atmanaha akasha sambhutaha. Forget about atma right now, but the tasmat brahmanaha, akasha sambhuta. Automatically all three things have come. Related to all the three, time, place and everything comes. Why? Creation means all the three. Creation means all the three. Time plus place plus objects. That is what the creation is. And therefore, he creates. The whole creation comes from him. Well, automatically that Karan Brahma is all related to all three. He is a creator of a time and place and all these objects. So already related. Because Karyam means all the three. And therefore, the Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, well, attributeless, relationless Brahman. And then same Brahman, after just two sentences, again comes Tasmat Brahmanam. From same Brahman, which is Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, from there Akasha came. Well, both the places, word Brahman should be taken differently in terms of meaning, even though word Brahman, single word is used. The context is different. Where one is in context, well, where they are, that's a Mahavakya actually. Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma is a Mahavakya. Because Yo Veda Nihitam Guhayam Parame Vyoman. That Brahman which has manifested in the Buddhi. Well, better you recognize that Brahman, Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, better you recognize in the Buddhi. And then in Buddhi, definitely, well, Aham Pratyaya is there. So you recognize this Aham Pratyaya as Brahman, Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma. You are Brahman. It's a Mahavakya. So there is no relation to creation. And then after two sentences, another two sentences, well, again tasmat Brahmanaha, from that Brahman, which is Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, well, the creation comes. Now context of creation. So don't take that Brahman. Yeah, which is Atma. Then, well, which I should take? I mean, Atma is Brahman, and that alone you can say in that way that is a Karan. But then you have to understand that is a Karan and Brahma means some factor must be there. Because that is free from any attributes, free from even attribute of Karanatvam, causality also. Free from relation to time, space, etc., everything. And that Brahman is definitely here taken as with attributes, etc. And therefore, Karya Sambandha is there. And therefore, we should be agile. We should be very agile when we study Shastra. Otherwise, it will create a little doubt regarding the Shastra. Anyway, so the unconnected Brahman well is definitely becomes getting connected for the Karanam, to the Karyam, etc. And therefore, that Brahman has to be taken as a Ishvara, which is Jagat Karanam, which is a Chidabhasa. Well, definitely Maya has to be brought in. Well, the creation comes means Maya has to be brought in. And therefore, it is automatically through Maya, it is Maya is a medium. And therefore, reflection will be there. So, Chidabhasa, that Chidabhasa is a Jagat Karanam. Therefore, generally, reflected consciousness is not called Brahman, but Ishvara, to avoid the confusion. But Shastra does not follow such rule. What we have to do, understand is that this reflected consciousness and this original, they are used. They are used sometime for Ishvara, they use Brahman, word use Brahman, or for Brahman they use Ishvara, etc. But so Shastra mixes up, but we don't, to avoid confusion, we should go by the context. Not only Shastra, in fact, Bhashyakara himself, Acharya himself use. Yeah, you sometimes Jeev Ishvara Aikyam they call, sometimes Jeev Brahma Aikyam they call. So Acharya also uses. I have seen several places in Bhashya. Instead, we feel, you are Ishvara, etc. We feel very much, what is this? So, but Acharya wants to convey that this is Brahman alone. And for Brahman, the Brahman is Jagat Karan, well, then Ishvara has to be. We have to understand it as Ishvara. And so this is how this has been used. But why all this jugglery? But then we are doing jugglery when we, in our vyavara we do. Yeah, we do. And we expect others to understand. We don't clarify. We expect others to understand. Even though you do this kind of usages. Like I said, my son is lion. Yeah. Then I expect that others, whoever has listened this sentence, I expect them to understand that you should not take it literally as a lion. My son is not a lion. He doesn't have four legs and all this mane and all the canine teeth, etc. I understand. I basically expect others to take it as my son is lion-like. Okay, my son is lion-like. I won't use that like. My son is lion. Therefore. You are using sun and lion are equated. My sun is lion means what? My sun and lion are equated. Can I expect others to take it literally? No. Therefore, this is how it is. And therefore, definitely they are, that is called Gauna Prayoga. That is what the Gauna Prayoga is. With understanding, I equate two things as one. It's called Gauna Prayoga. So I compare in terms of guna. When two things are equated, shown as a one. Therefore, definitely in terms of guna, I equate. Yeah, in terms of guna, my son is like a lion. Yeah, yes, that's how it is. And therefore, and we also don't object, right? If we listen to this sentence of our friend and he is admiring his son like this, we also don't object. What are you saying? ये सन एंड लायन कैन नॉट बी वन, यू ऑल्सो नो. सो दिस कॉल्ड गौण प्रयोग. एंड इफ यू इफ इफ वन डज नॉट अंडरस्टैंड देन इट इज कॉल्ड मिथ्या प्रत्यय. गौण प्रत्यय मीन्स विथ अ नॉलेज टू थिंग्स आर इक्वेटेड. And when two things are equated, but with ignorance, at not knowing two things, I take it as one. Like jiva is taken as, I mean, Brahman is taken as a jiva, right? Even though I am a consciousness, but I take myself as a reflection only. So that's out of ignorance, and therefore, definitely that's a mithya pratyaya. That's called adhyasa. Anyo anya adhyasa. Jiva is superimposed upon the Brahman, Chidabhasa is superimposed upon the Brahman, Chit, and Chit is taken as a Chidabhasa. Chit is not superimposed upon it. Some people say like that. Chidabhasa is superimposed upon Chit, and Chit is superimposed upon Chidabhasa. Never say that. Never say. What is superimposed is a mithya thing. Therefore, if Chaitanya is superimposed upon Chidabhasa, means what? Chaitanya is mithya? What are you saying? And therefore, never use this word. That's how, we have this anyonya adhyasa, but we have to understand it. Well, definitely Chidabhasa is superimposed upon the Chaitanyam. And also attributes of Chidabhasa, like, the attributes of the body, attributes of the mind, attributes of the prana, all are superimposed upon Chaitanyam also. Dharmi adhyasa as well as dharma adhyasa, both. But then Chaitanyam is equated with the Chidabhasa. We have to take like that. We have to understand it that way. And therefore, this is anyonya adhyasa, out of ignorance. Two things taken as one. So it is a mithya pratyaya. When two things are taken as one, with understanding, with knowledge, it's a gauna prayoga, gauna pratyaya. So this is how we have to understand. So, here Acharya says, anyonya adhyasa rupaha. Asav means this. This is anyonya adhyasa. Means definitely, it is taken, Ishvara is taken as a Brahman and Brahman is taken as Ishvara, or Brahman is taken as a Jagat Karanam, you can say. Well, that is, if one doesn't know, then it is definitely mithya pratyaya. That there are two things. One is Chidabhasa only. Through Maya only, Brahman becomes Jagat Karanam. That's called Ishvara. To avoid the confusion, we have another word, etc. So, why Upanishad does? Because Upanishad joins ignorant people and deliberately mixing up. That's how, for on the part of Upanishad, it is a gauna pratyaya. On the part of a jiva, taking Brahman and Ishvara as a one is a mithya pratyaya. So this is how we have to understand. So, and then Sureshwara Acharya ji also does the same thing. He also mixed up and he said, Paraha Karanatam Eti. Param Brahma is a Karanam. So then we have to understand that he knows definitely. And therefore, from his part, it is a Gauna Pratyaya. But the Purupakshi was not knowing and he said, well, Vidyaranya Swamiji, you are saying Ishvara is a Jagat Karanam. And Sureshwara Acharya ji says, Param Brahman is a Jagat Karanam. Then how will I understand? Ishvara means a Chidabhasa. And Param Brahma, which is a original, well, this is a consciousness. How can both be taken as a one? Well, with understanding, it has been taken as a one. Sureshwara Acharya refers to Param Brahma available as reflected consciousness and Maya only. Definitely, original consciousness is different. Asangam, reflected consciousness is always connected to the medium. And in fact, that is how it is. The Sarveshwaratvam, Sarvajnyatvam, and Antaryamitvam, and Jagat Karanam, all this due to Maya. All due to Maya. So, Brahman, one sings the glory of a Brahman on account of Maya. There is no glory, in fact, of Brahman. Honestly, there is no glory. What is a glory? Any glory is a superimposition on Brahman. There is no glory. Nirgunam Brahma, Ashabdam, Asparsham, Arupam, Arasam, Nityam, Agandhavat. No glory at all. Brahman has a no glory. Any glory is basically on account of Maya. Either you call Ishvara, Maya. Sa Antaryami, Maya. Karma Phaladata, Maya. Omniscient, Maya. omnipotent, Maya. Oh, creator, Maya. Sustainer, Maya. Resolver, Maya. Laws, order, Maya. Everything. Everything, Maya. Law of karma, oh, Maya. Ishvara has formulated the law of karma. And then now he rules through the law of karma. So he is a Sarvashakti. So he created all the laws, entire order. Well, varieties of the orders, psychological, physical order and physiological order. Several orders are created, biological order. So many orders he created. He is the order, the order. Yeah, Maya. Okay? And therefore, all karyakarana sambandha, all action, reaction, whatever, cause, effect. Generally, order means cause, effect. Or action, reaction also. That is also order. Yeah. So, well, human mind reacts in a certain way. And the donkey's mind reacts in a certain way in a given situation. So, this situation means human will react like this. And this situation, the donkey will react like this. It's order. It's order. Basically. And therefore, anyway, what I'm saying is all glory. Brahman doesn't have a glory. Ishvara has all the glory. Therefore, Ishvara is not Brahman. Ishvara and Brahman are different things. Different thing is, Ishvara is non-separate from Brahman. Now, I should not say again and again. So, same Brahman and with the Maya, we say, definitely become, say, well, getting reflected in the Maya and become, say, Karanam, etc. And so, this difference has to be clearly known. So, in Mahavakya, Tattvamasi, etc., the equation between that Jiva and this Ishvara, or well, will be at what level? At all the levels? All three levels, right? And therefore, there is a reflected consciousness. There is a reflecting medium. And there is original. Jiva also has all the three. Original consciousness. That is consciousness. And reflected consciousness, Chidabhasa. And reflecting medium, Avidya. So, well, Mahavakya says Jiva and Ishvara are one. So, all the levels, there is a equation possible? No. At only one level. At only one level. And that is, both are basically consciousness, Brahman, original, etc. So, at one level, there is equation possible. Not at all the levels. Anyway. So, Vidyaranya says, we should know what is what. Brantya ekatam gataha. So there is a oneness between this reflected consciousness and this original. In Taittiriya, if someone says like that, I mean, Brantya ekatam gata, satyam jnanam anantam brahma, that Brahman alone from which the akasha came. Oh, therefore Brahman is really a jagat karan. No, Brahman is karya karan vilakshanam. And therefore if someone takes this ekatam, that Ishvara, Jagat Karanam actually, and because the word Brahman is used and he literally takes it, that Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma alone is a Jagat Karanam, and he literally takes it as a one. That's a Bhrantya, that's a Bhranti, that's an ignorance. He has mixed up. What is that mixing up? Anyonya Adhyasa Rupam, he says. So, and nicely brings that Pata Drashtanta, which he has given long ago. He has that canvas, painting on canvas, that drashtanta we have seen, right? So, drashtanta, it was there in four stages, right? And so, one first stage was a dhautapata. I am reminding you, dhautapata. And so, dhautapata means that original canvas, white. Dhautam means basically white, stainless. And then, second stage will be what? Gattitapata. Gattitapata means, well, it has been starched. So, Gattitapata. And the third one is a Lanchitapata. Then on that, after, it has been starched properly, or let's say that, dipped in starch and dried it, and then there are outlines drawn for the painting. And that is a Lanchitapata. And the fourth one will be what? Painting, right? And so it's called Puritapata. Some colors you will fill up. And so that is how these four stages of that painting has been shown from the canvas, the cloth, original cloth. Same way here also, same thing. So dhautapataha means a plain cloth, stainless cloth basically, has been compared to this Brahman, original. And well, on that first thing is done is a gattitapataha. So I mean, there it is gattitapataha. So here it is, well, definitely starched. So with the maya, okay? So this original has been deepened into a basically, you know, a maya. Now it is along with the maya, associated to maya. There it is associated with the starch. Now here it is associated with the maya. That's called Ishvara. So dhautapata is different. That basically, and the starch cloth is different, and this pure canvas is different. Starch canvas is different. And that same way, Brahman is different. Ishvara is different, naturally. Otherwise, on the directly you can do on that pure canvas, but nobody does. First they do the starch. But somebody who does painting told me, Swamiji, you are wrong, and Vidyaranya is also wrong. Nobody does this anyway. That's up to Vidyaranya and you. Whatever you want to discuss with, you please discuss with him. But this is what he shown. He has shown like this. Anyway, so outlines. And then the third stage will be what? Okay, first is a Brahman. Second is a Ishvara associated to the Maya, starch. Then the third stage will be what? Outlines. Outlines of whatever you want to paint. And that is Lanchita, right? And that is what here in our case, Hiranyagarbha. Well, right? From basically after associating with the Maya, the first thing comes out is a whole subtle prapancha. So that subtle prapancha, and so Brahman associated with that subtle prapancha is like a lines on that canvas. So Hiranyagarbha is the fourth stage. And then painting was complete, Purita Pataha, their colors are filled up. And here in our case, all varieties of the names and forms. Variety means variety. So many colors and so many forms, and so definitely entire. So that is a Virat Purusha. So Shuddha Chaitanya, Brahman, then Ishvara, Antaryami, third is the Hiranyagarbha, and fourth is a Virat. There also four. Dautapataha, pure canvas, and then starch deepened canvas, and then, well, definitely we have that outlines, etc. Canvas with have outlines, and then colored all that. So now, so this basically, so Shuddha Chaitanya is associated with the Maya starch. That's a Ishvara. Ready for the universal. Universe, ready for the painting, called universe. That has been told in a little differently. Vishwam darpana drishyamana nagari tulyam nijantargatam, etc., etc. So anyway, so when there is a, then still, since the pure canvas and the starch dependent canvas are different, naturally different, and if somebody takes it as a one, that's a mistake. Same way original consciousness and this reflected consciousness, well, the consciousness associated with the Maya starch cannot be taken as a one, and somebody takes it, well, that is a Bhranti. That's what he gives the example here. So, yatha anna lipta pataha. Annam is starch. Basically, because there in those days, starch they used to derive from either through potatoes or some other grains or something. Maybe I think rice or. So, but not in those days. Even in nowadays also, many people, you know, they don't have a starch powder. Then what they do is this. Definitely, they, you know, once you make a rice, and then that water, etc., has a lot of starch, and that so they you know, just filter it and take that water. So yatha anna lipta pataha. So pataha means shuddha pataha, and anna lipta pataha means basically a starch dependent canvas or a cloth. And then so gattitena ekata me eti. So that pata which is shuddham, the canvas, pure canvas, well definitely ekata has been taken with the starch, and therefore it was taken as a one by somebody, then it is not correct. Same way Brahman and Ishvara should not be mixed up in terms of understanding. You may use a one word. Or let Shastra use. Let Shastra, you may not use. But then you understand in an appropriate context. If Srishti etc. is there, the context, creation is there, take it as a Ishvara. And if that context is not there and Asangoyam Purusha etc. etc. or Mahavakya etc. is there, Aham Brahmasmi etc. is there, then you have to take it as a Nirgunam Brahmasmi. Well, or basically Brahman without attributes, of even Karanam etc. Karya Karanam Vilakshan Brahma you should take. Let's go to 194.
Megha kasha maha kashau vivichyete napamarehi tadvad brahmeshayo raikyam pashyantyapata darshinah.
And we should remember he gave two examples there. In the beginning of this chapter itself, one example was of this pata. Right? Chitrapata. That's how the name of this chapter also. Chitrapata. Chitra Deepa Prakrana. Anyway, then the second one example he gave there is Akasha. There are also four types of Akasha. Pata also four types, and this Akasha also four types. And so he is reminding that also now. First he talked about the Mahakasha, original space, and all-pervading, which is all-pervading Mahakasha. And then there is a cloud appear there in the Mahakasha and with plenty of water droplets. Not just cloud without water. Megaha means that's how they defined the difference. Megaha word indicates a cloud, but it's a rain-bearing cloud or with a water droplets. And definitely if that is there, then Mahakasha will be reflected in that cloud. And that reflected Akasha will be called Megha Akasha. So Megha Akasha is available in that cloud. And definitely Mahakasha will be there, natural Megha. So reflected space is there. Then Mahakasha should be there. Otherwise, how will the reflection will be there? Reflection cannot be independent. And therefore, Mahakasha also is there. So two Akashas are there where the cloud is there. And when cloud goes away, well, Megha Akasha goes away. Reflection goes away, naturally. Reflected space goes away. But Mahakasha will remain. And Mahakasha remains means what? Mahakasha has not gone anywhere, in fact. Mahakasha cannot come and Mahakasha cannot go. So that is what the Mahakasha is. Reflection can come and go. That happens. That is to be remembered. That is how we always say for a Jnani. So then, well, Brahmani Sthitaha. Brahmavid Brahmani Sthitaha. Then, while living, he is Brahman. And, well, when one's body will go, then what will be there? Yeah, Brahman will remain. Okay? So, Brahmavid Brahmani Sthitaha means what? The knower of Brahman abides in Brahman. Means what? While living, he is Brahman. When body drops, then Prarabdha goes away. Still, he is Brahman. Yeah. What will happen, Swamiji? Because body goes away, then nothing will remain. Because his gross body will merge into gross elements. Subtle body will merge into subtle elements. Causal body has already become, is like an old person. You know, because Ajnanam has gone, Vasanas are gone, no Agami Karma, nothing. That also merges into a Maya. Then for nothing will remain. After the death of a wise person, nothing will remain. Ye kya baat hai? So while living, he is Brahman, and while after the body is dropped, he is Brahman. He is all pervading Brahman. Okay? And therefore, and still if you want some more, he is Ishvara. He is Ishvara. Because subtle gross body has gone into gross prapancha. Subtle body has gone into subtle prapancha. Understand that. Where will it go? Vashti goes to Samashti. And therefore, he is Ishvara. Where is the question of what? Somebody asked me this question. Swamiji, everything goes. His eyes also has become like, he's as if he is going to be a non-existent. He is going to be a non-existent thing. He is all existence. He is existence. He is Brahman now and he is Brahman later. That is his vision. Our vision is like that. He will merge into Brahman, etc. That is not his vision. His vision is I am Brahman. and I will be Brahman. And I was Brahman. No question of going and coming and anything. So far the question of going, coming, birth, death, all this still, that jiva is there. The jivatvam is there. I was born, but now I will not be born. Start with Tattva Bodha. That's better. I was born, but I will not be born again. I was born, but I will not be born again. That's a jiva. That's a jiva. Where is the question of Brahman? Where is the question of Janma, Marana, etc.? Where is the question of going, coming, etc.? This going, coming business, all with a reflected consciousness. Reflection can come and go, and it goes. Every day it goes. Every day it resolves. Therefore, you are not jiva. Proves so beautifully it is. You are not jiva. Otherwise, who knows that the jiva, this chidabhasa goes? Who knows? There is someone who is left out, who is left over. Where the pramatrutvam, kartrutvam, bhoktrutvam, everything goes. The individuality goes. And you are able to understand, I am able to understand this. We all have experienced that. Otherwise, I could not talk to you. If it is a special experience of me, how can I talk to you about that? When I say this, you are able to understand. You don't definitely have any objection to that. Where is the question of going and coming for the Brahman? In that Brahman he abides. Brahmavid Brahmani Sthita. So basically, this he knows that I am Brahman. He doesn't say I am knower of Brahman. I am Brahman who never goes, never comes. And therefore, Megha Kasha can go, definitely. Megha goes, Megha Kasha goes. Mahakasha cannot go, cannot come. Anyway, Megha Kasha is born also. Megha Kasha is born also. Anyway, so they coexist in one place. They coexist in one place. Megha Kasha, well, and this Mahakasha coexist in one place. And that is why people commit a mistake. When both are at one place, you take it one as the other, not knowing there are two. Where the jiva is, there the Brahman is. Jiva is non-separate from Brahman, that is what the mithyatvam is. Where the snake is, there the rope is. Not knowing two, you take the one as a two, other one. You take I am sarpaha, this is snake. Well, this is indicating Rajju is there. This goes to the Vyavarika Rajju. And Sarpa, which is a Pradibhasikam, has been equated with that. Same with this Chidabhasa Jiva, which is Mithya, has been equated with the Satyam Brahma, which is Paramarthika. All this is possible Anyonya Dhyasa. That's a Mithya Pratyaya. Definitely. So this is another example. Where the Megakasha is, there the Mahakasha is. But one takes just Megakasha as the Akasha. That's a mistake. So Megakasha Mahakashau. Megakasha, we have seen that. Megakasham is Mega Pratibimbita Akasha. And that is Megakasha. And definitely the other one is a Mahakasha. So this basically these two Akashas are not understood clearly. Navivichyate, they are not discriminated, because where is the question of discrimination between the two? That one is the original, other is a Chidava, reflected Akasha. Where is the question of discrimination? Where you don't know that there are two. But why is such a mistake? Because where the reflection, there the original. And therefore, definitely, and the mistake can occur. If both are at different place, then their mistake would not occur. But where the reflection, there the original, then definitely Pamaraihi Navivichyate. So by this people who are ignorant is not clearly understood them as a two. They don't recognize it. So when reflected space is there, Mahakasha is there but not recognized. Tadvat in the same way, means like an example, Brahma Ishayoho Aikyam Pashyanti. So ignorant people see Aikyam, oneness between Brahman and Ishvara. That's not true. And because of what? Apata Darshinaha. Because of Well, apatadarshina, because of the superfluous, you know, study, because of this superficial study, well, definitely they say Brahman is karanam, asangam Brahman is taken as a sasangam, right? One which is free from karanakarya relationship is taken as a karanam for the jagat, etc. Akaranam Brahman is taken as a karanam Brahma, asangam Brahman is taken as a sasangam Brahma, etc. So, because both will be at one place only. I mean, both will be together only. And one is a Chidabhasa, other is a Chit. 195.
Upakramadi birlingaihi tatparyasya vicharanat asangam brahma mayavi surjatyesha maheshwarah.
So then Acharya feels, Acharya became literally serious now. He said, why should you be apatadarshi? Why should you have such a superfluous study? Study well. So don't study in a superficial manner. Any Upanishad, don't study in a superficial manner. Study should be done, thorough study should be done. Systematic study should be done for a length of time and with a teacher and etc. etc. So, and the study should be done means at least Shravanam should be done. Basically, that's the only thing. Shravanam is the main thing. And therefore, study the Shastra well through the teacher with the six lingas. Keep this thing in the mind. Upakramadi lingaihi. Upakramadi lingaihi. So, upakrama, upasamharo, abhyasaha, apurvata, phalam, etc. etc. What is in the beginning? What is in the end? I told you yesterday, right? Imagine how this madhvas, etc. will take, they also take the support of the Upanishad. But they just stick to this Srushti Vakya. And they feel that the Srushti Vakya indicates Ishvara. And Ishvara is a one who has created the Jagat, who has created Jivas. And Ishvara is the one who will give Moksha also, definitely. Because Jiva feels a bondage in the world. But the world is created by Ishvara only. And therefore Jiva is automatically feeling a bondage living in the world. And therefore Ishvara will give him a Moksha. Ishvara is a moksha pradaha, they call. Giving moksha. So surrender to him. And there is a Jiva and Ishvara are not one. Naturally. One who gives moksha. Ishvara, he is free from the bondage. Ishvara. This Jiva is having a bondage. How can these Vedantins talk about this Jiva Ishvara Ikyam? These Dvaitvadis. So what is the purport of the Upanishad has to be understood. Whether the purport is in Srushti Vakya or that is Jiva Ishvara Bheda, Ishvara is Jagat Karanam and therefore, well, he created Jagat and Jiva both. That's the purport of the Upanishad, or the purport of the Upanishad is a Mahavakya. So, Upakramadi Shadlingaihi. One has to understand this. Well, through this lingas, we have done that in Chandogya, right? We have taken that, not in Chandogya, but we have taken these six factors through that Chandogya Vakya. So, linga, well, definitely means a sign, basically. All the varieties of the, in Upanishad statements, well, that is an indication of a particular factor. So what is in the beginning? Sadeva Samedamagra Asit Ekameva Dvitiyam. The Sat alone was there before creation. Why don't you look into that? You are saying Srishti Vakya is a purport. But look into that. What was there before creation? Just see. Sadeva Samedamagra Asit Ekameva Dvitiyam. There was nothing other than Sat. If nothing other than Sat and from that Sat the whole creation comes, then what is this creation? Nothing other was there before the whole world of these pots and pans and everything came. Nothing was there other than the clay. Oh, and from there only this whole thing has come? Yeah. Then what is there right now? So common sense, right? That everything is just clay. Everything is just clay. Then it is Dvaitam or Advaitam? It is Dvaitam or Advaitam. Could you follow what I am saying? So names and forms you see many, and therefore you say this there is manyness. Well, that is not correct. That's not correct. And neha nana asti kinchana. Dahiya nana asti kinchana. Mrityo samrutyu mahaploti. there is no maniness here. If someone sees a well, one as a many, taken maniness as a reality, where the reality is just a oneness, definitely he is going to get a capital punishment. Yeah. Mrityosya mrityum apnoti. Yaha nana pashyati. Yaha pashyati. One who sees iha in this creation, asmin loke, maniness, is going to gain capital punishment. So we should understand what is the purport of the Shastra. One should not have the vision of maniness, dvaitam. I could not talk yesterday all these things because it becomes too much, but I am saying, so if one Upanishad becomes a source book for a dvaitavada and advaitavada, we ourselves may have a problem after the class. Yeah, that is true. I should also take this Srishti Vakya as the reality. And then dvaitam alone. And yeah, everyone, people cannot be fooled. Maybe Muktatma or other people may be fooled, but people, other people take it as the duality alone is a reality. And therefore, well, in the Upanishad also talks about duality. And therefore, that only is the purport of the Shastra. No, not at all. Upakramadi Shadlingaihi. Decide what is in the beginning, what is in the end. Even in Taittiriya also itself, Vidyarana will quote later. Yeah, in Taittiriya, because we have started with the Taittiriya, you know, Asatyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, and then repeatedly, the whole creation, and then, etc. So he will show, don't worry, Upakrama, Upasamhara, beginning, what is in the beginning, what is in the end, and that is one of the factors. That's one of the factors to decide the purport of the Shastra, the subject matter of the Shastra, etc. Anyway, so the central teaching of the Shastra, Tatparisya Vicharanat, through inquiry with this Shadlingas, and we arrive at the central teaching of the Shastra, Advaitam or Dvaitam. And so, well, then definitely you will find Asangam Brahma alone. So, well, Brahman which is Asangam, Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, which is not a cause, effect, etc., that alone is a purport, and that is equated with the Atma, actually, that is a Mahavakya, and the Supreme Mahavakya is a Mahavakya. Okay, therefore Srishti Vakya is Avantara Vakya. Okay, so we arrive at this Mahavakya, means we are telling them as a Mahavakya because of this reason, because that's the central teaching. Jiveshwara Aikyam is a central teaching. And therefore, that is the Apurvata. Yeah, so many things are there. How many things I get? Apurvata, right? Apurvata means what? Pramana should reveal something which cannot be revealed by any other thing. Then dvaitam cannot be basically if Shastra's purport is a dvaitam, then Shastra is no more a pramana. Shastra is repeating what I already know. Pramana is a pramana which will generate a knowledge which is anadigatam, abaditam. Anadigatam, which cannot be known through any other means of knowledge. That is how I has a status of a pramana. I says that for color, you will have to use me only. No way. Whatever may be the yoni, it may be a yoni of a lion, or it may be a yoni of a mosquito, anywhere. A form, color, etc. will be known through me only in the whole creation. That's true. That's how I got a status of a pramana, means of knowledge. A means of knowledge will generate a data or gives a knowledge which cannot be known through any other means of knowledge. Therefore, Shastra should give you a knowledge which cannot be known through any other means of knowledge. Your perception reveals that there are many things. Well, then why Shastra is required for that? For Dvaitam, you need not go. In fact, one is born with the Dvaitam. One is born with the Dvaitam. Having that I am different, you are different. What Shastra is? What Shastra has to convey? Shastra has not to convey this. You know already. That if Shastra has to convey to you something, well, which is not known through any other means of knowledge. That's Apurvata. Apurvata. Well, that is one of the linga. And therefore, Advaitam. In spite of maniness, there is a oneness. Yeah. That's a reality. And therefore, the maniness is a mithya, which will be experienced all the time. No problem. But there is a thread which pervades all these forms, names and forms. That's a reality. That's a dvaitam. Anyway, so that's how apurvata, phalam, And then for such a jnanam, advaita jnanam, there is a phalam. Therefore, that is a purport. Upapatti, reasoning has been given. Reasoning means, well, tarka. We have seen we have taken the example of the clay and the pot and etc. And we proved that yes, karanam is one, karyams are many, and all karyas are mithya, because karya resolves into karanam, and as such also where the karya is there, actually karana only pervades all the karyas, and therefore karyam is mithya. What is really there is a karanam only, and that is Brahman, of course. And so, anyway, we have seen these sixfold factors. So, asangam brahma, that is tatparyasya vicharanat. And therefore, Brahman is satyam, which is free from this karana, karya, etc. And therefore, well, definitely, if the karya is mithya, then there is no real creation. Well, from the clay, you say all pots came. Then, well, if pot is a clay, basically, therefore there is really, then pot also is a clay. And well, pot was not that, there was also clay. Then what is the creation? So there is no real creation? No, there is no real creation. There is no real creation. That's what Mandukya said, right? Third chapter and fourth chapter also. So Gaudapada, struggled to prove that. Na kashchit jayate jivaha sambhavo asya na vidyate. Etat uttamam satyam yat kinchit na jayate. Third chapter and fourth chapter. Third chapter 48 verse. And fourth chapter 71st, well, very clearly shows there is no creation. Ajatavada. So, mithya creation, I mean. So, really, because all parts, spans, everything is clay. And before all they, are created, there was clay. Then clay and clay. Cause is clay, part, effect also is clay. Then what is the creation? There is no real creation. Yeah, that is what it is. So before creation, Sadeva Somedamagra Asit, before that there was Sat, and now also is, Sarvam Khalu Idam Brahma, that also is same Sat. Then where is creation? That's what we say. And therefore, so Dvaitam is Mithya basically. Creation is Mithya means Dvaitam is Mithya. Anyway, I'm six systems of philosophy is little bit now, here in Panchadashi little bit goes along with now. Because there I will not have much scope to say. But now this thing will resolve ours in our own way. So basically, then why? Okay. There is no creation. Okay. Then why Upanishad describe creation? This Dashopanishad, everywhere creation is there. Well, we say this whole creation is an empirical version of Brahman. Jiva is also empirical version of the Brahman. Okay. And therefore, empirical version. For Vyavara, all this thing is there. For a joy. So, Brahman wears two Vesha, Jiva and Jagat. And then this, there will be a transaction there. That's all. One wears a Vesha of a Karta, Bhokta, Pramata. And the other wears a Vesha of a Prameya, etc. And therefore, this Vesha, Vyavara, will continue. So, then definitely, so this is, that's a Mithya actually. So, just like, and therefore, basically, this whole Vesha is, don't take that Brahman as with the Vesha. Don't take Brahman as a Jiva, don't take Brahman as a Jagat, etc. Don't take Brahman as a creator of Jagat, etc. also. That also is a Vesha through Maya. And therefore, so reflection, in terms of reflection, they cannot. If Jiva is also Brahman and Jagat also is Brahman, then where is the difference? Yeah, difference is still there. Difference is still there. Like a reflection. Well, that's another thing. Before I go to the example. Yeah, between Jiva and Ishvara also. If you say Ishvara is Brahman, Jiva is Brahman, then where is the question of the difference between Jiva and Ishvara? No, there will be a difference. Now there is a difference? Yeah, there is a difference. Because the reflection will be always different. Your reflection in a concave mirror and reflection in a convex mirror are different. So, well, even though you are one, but the reflections are not one. Reflections are different. Same way Jiva and Ishvara, even there also difference will be there. You say Jiva is Brahman, Ishvara is Brahman. Well, then there should not be any Jiva and Ishvara word at all. And you say not only words are there, meanings are also different. Yeah, meanings are different. Reflections are always different, depending upon the medium. Yes, reflection will be different. And so in Ahmedabad, they have one mirror house in which they keep different types of mirror. And they tell you to stand in the center. And so many types of mirrors. And everywhere your reflection is different. Somewhere your face will be very, very long face. Generally, you don't give a long face because you are a very smiling person. But then there you will find yourself with a long face. And body will be very short. Or the face is very, very, you know, small. And the body is long. And somewhere you are look very, you know, I mean, all kinds of reflections are there. So how many of you are there? Only one. But still, reflections will be many. One reflection is different from the other. So same way, Jiva and Ishvara, both are Chidabhasa. And therefore, essentially, Jiva is Brahman and Ishvara is Brahman. But Jiva and Ishvara also, in terms of reflection, there is a difference. Chidabhasas are different. Because of reflecting medium, one is a Maya, there is a Vidya, etc. So anyway, but original consciousness, that is Asangam, definitely Asangam. And so one becomes a creator. Mayavi Eshaha Bhavati, Maheshwaraha, says Vidyaranya. Well, he is a Maheshwaraha, he is a creator, and he creates. And so, and Jiva is another version, Vyavarika version of the Brahman, as a Jiva who is created, etc. So this will be there. Essentially, that is Brahman alone. Jiva is Brahman, Ishvara is Brahman, but one is a creator, another is a created through the different upadis, etc. Okay, so now 196, etc. We'll see it tomorrow, day after tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.